संस्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणे अवतारवरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयो श्रुत्वा प्रणमामि महोर्मुहुः नमः श्रीयतिराजाय विवेकानन्दसूरये सच्चित्सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे. So this is the chapter Sri Ramakrishna with the devotees. Is the Nava Yatra. There is a 9-day car festival. So you know, it was a very remarkable period of 9 days, during which, you know, several facets of Sri Ramakrishna's personality have been discussed by Sharat Maharaj. How we know, of course, you know, it was very difficult for them. You know, they themselves were very great. You know, Sharat Maharaj and others were not ordinary people. They were extraordinary spiritual giants. In fact, no, I think when somebody asked him about this book, he said, "I have never written anything beyond my own spiritual experience." So you can imagine how great he was as a spiritual personality. Even then, the expressions he uses about Sri Ramakrishna, jab kuch batane chahte, to he goes to such levels. He says, we couldn't even imagine that such things were possible. In a human body, such demonstration of such supreme powers of spiritual greatness. So that's why he would, through certain incidents, you know, the way he dealt with Pandit Sashadhar and some other incidents, that clearly again bring out Sri Ramakrishna's supreme spiritual eminence. That is the main drift in this topic. So on the first day, Sri Ramakrishna first went to Ishan Mukhopadhyay's house at Tantaniya Kalibadi, near that, in the Tantaniya in Calcutta. Jo saath ho jogin hajra ho kisi kai devotees ki bhi lege. So you know, and then his one of his sons, he had 8 sons, and all of them were very highly educated. The third son, Satish, was a very good pakwaj player. Bahut achhe bajate the. Isliye Swamiji beech beech mein used to go to his house and sing. And you know, Swamiji somewhere says he was no less philanthropist than Ishwar Shagar Vidyasagar himself. Hum sabko jante hain Ishwar Shagar Vidyasagar was such a great, itni bade prasiddh the unki, his qualities of charity. Itne bade बहुत बहुत कुछ दान करते थे सबको. सो मेनी बी एनी बडी नो बडी वुड बी रिफ्यूज इफ दे गो टू हिम. बट ही सेज ईशान वॉज नो लेस, क्योंकि कई बार उन्होंने देखा जो खाना अपने के लिए रखा पूरा दे दिया, भूखा रहा, क्योंकि देयर वॉज नो अदर कुक्ड फूड लेफ्ट इन द हाउस. और किसी को नहीं कर पाते तो ही यूज टू वीप सो मच, इतनी रोते थे क्या मैं कुछ नहीं कर पाया इनको ऐसा. एट द सेम टाइम ही वॉज कम्प्लीटली आउट एंड आउट ए साधका. बहुत सुबह से शाम तक 4 बजे तक जब ध्यान करके उसके बाद थोड़ा कुछ लेते थे, फिर संध्या काल से फिर शुरू करते थे. ही वॉज सच ए ग्रेट साधक हिमसेल्फ. सो ठाकुर हैड ग्रेट अफेक्शन फॉर दिस ईशान. बीच बीच में जाते थे. उस दिन उन्होंने घर पे गया, ही हैड गॉन. वी रिमेंबर दैट वन इवनिंग आफ्टर फिनिशिंग हिज जपा, ईशान बोर डाउन एट द मास्टर्स फीट. इस दिन नहीं, दूसरा किसी दिन की घटना. And the master in ecstasy touched Ishan's head with his feet. When the master later regained normal consciousness, he told Ishan emphatically, "O Brahmin, dive deep, dive deep. Doob thou, doob thou." In other words, become absorbed in the name of God instead of superficially repeating a mantra. Socho, sab subah se saam tak somebody is doing japa. Ek din, do din nahi hai. Hum log to 6 mahine mein ek baar baithenge, itna nahi hai. Every day after day, morning to evening, this person is doing. Itna nahi hai, uske baad thoda kuch leke fir thoda baatchit karte the, ba kuch devotional gana ko sunte the, fir uske baad fir sandhya se fir jap mein baith jate the. Still he is seeing, Thakur saying, that's not enough. Itna nahi hai, fir tum gehrai se jao, there is not enough. you go deep. So, you know, we can understand how, what it is to be really deeply immersed or involved in spiritual practice. So quite often we think that thoda yahan kuch baithi hai, thoda kuch jap kiya. These are all, yes, these are all good, no doubt. But going completely deep and getting immersed in that, naturally only Sri Ramakrishna alone can know, and he alone could instruct also. Na? And nor do we know what it is to really become so involved. Anyway, so he was, that is why saying, at that time, Ishan was performing worship and japa from morning till 4 in the afternoon. After a light meal, he would talk to people or listen to devotional songs. Later in the evening, he would resume practicing japa for several hours. So anyway, he would go to Thakur and meet him also. On the day of Khar festival, Master went to Ishan's house and had spiritual discussions with some Brahmin scholars from Bhatpara. But the Master heard from Swami Vivekananda that Pandit Sashadhar was staying nearby. So he went to see him that day. So Swamiji pehle unke bare mein sune the, isliye kai baar jaake mila tha. But then Swamiji saw that, you know, some of his explanations of the scriptural truths were not perfect according to his understanding. Isliye bahut unke saath tark bhi jod dete the. So us din Sri Ramakrishna bhi le gaya. Swamiji took Master to meet the Pandit. And on that day, the Master gave Pandit some valuable instructions. During his first visit, the Master told the Pandit, if one tries to teach religion without a command or authority from the Divine Mother, one's efforts will be totally fruitless. Sometimes the attempt inflates a preacher's pride and egoism, leading that person down the path of destruction. After, so, us din Thakur unke bataya, आपके बिना भगवान के आदेश के बिना माँ के आदेश के बिना आप कुछ प्रचार करने लगे तो बहुत ही मुश्किल है क्योंकि यू बिकम ईगोइस्टिक अहंकार बढ़ जाएगा देन तो पतन तो अनिवार्य है जरूर इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट सो देन यू नो आफ्टर हियरिंग आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू दिस ग्रेट फियरी एंड पावरफुल वर्ड्स द मास्टर द पंडित स्टॉप प्रीचिंग and went to Khamakya to practice disciplines. Unhone sab chhod phod ke Khamakya wahan chale gaye sadhan karne ke liye. In the evening, after taking leave of the Pandit, the Master went with Jogin to Balram's house at Bagh Bazar. At that time, Jogin was strictly observing caste rules regarding food. Mani ji, subah to Ishan ki ghar pe bahut kuch hua, din wahan se Pandit ki paas chale gaye, wahan bahut baatein kiya, unko bhi bahut kuch samjhaya. Then, again, evening he went to Balram's house. So, Sat, O Yogin Maharaj, Baad mein Yogin Maharaj hua, bhi, it was only Yogin, O bhi Sri Ramakrishna Sahib ki hai. Lekin he was very strict about his food habits. Kahan bahar kuch nahi, paani bhi nahi lete the. Lekin Sri Ramakrishna unke pehle hi bataya tha, Balram ki ghar itna sab, unki charitra itna pavitra hai, wahan sab tum kuch le sakte ho, phal ityadi. Lekin that day, usually he did not ask Yogin to eat anything because he knew of the strictness according to food. But after observing Balram's devotion, the Master and faith in the Master, Yogin would sometimes take milk, sweets, etc. Shortly arriving at Balram's house, the Master said to him, "Hello, Yogin has not eaten anything since morning. Please give him some food." वो जानते थे लेकिन उस दिन फिर भी बताया उनके लेके कुछ खिलाओ देन बलराम टुक हिम एंड फेड हिम सम्प्टुअसली एंड उस दिन ही डिड नॉट इवन माइंड टेकिंग फूड इन बलराम्स हाउस सो ना इसी से दिस इज व्हाट शरतमा इज ट्राइंग टू राइट ऑल्दो यू नो सुबह से शाम तक ऐसा उन्होंने समय बिताया लेकिन उस समय जाके भी उन्होंने याद रखा सुबह से योगिन कुछ नहीं लिया उसको कुछ खिलाना जरूरत है See, normally, no, if you people think that we are little advanced, then we have no time to pay attention to other existential matters or matters of normal, our life. But here he was, as an example of how the Master, even though he was often absorbed in ecstasy, still paid attention to the physical and mental needs of his devotees. Jinke jaisi prayojan hai, jaisi jarurat hai, वैसे ही व्यवस्था कर देते। वो जानते थे उस दिन सुबह से उस समय तक योगिन कुछ नहीं लिया था, इसलिए उनका खाना का भी व्यवस्था किया। ड्यूरिंग द कार फेस्टिवल एट बलराम्स हाउस, ए करंट ऑफ ब्लिस फ्लोड अमंग दोज इन द कंपनी ऑफ द मास्टर। शॉर्टली आफ्टर सनसेट द इमेज ऑफ जगन्नाथ वॉज अडॉर्न विद गार्लैंड्स एंड सैंडल पेस्ट एंड ब्रॉट फ्रॉम द इनर फैमिली श्राइन टू द फ्रंट पार्ट ऑफ द हाउस। The image was then placed in a small chariot that was decorated with cloth and flags. Fakir Balram's family priest and also a devotee, the master, performed the worship. Abhi bhi har saal wahan Balram mandir mein hi utsav ho raha hai. So now it's bahut hi ek romance ki baat hai. If you go particularly that day, again that crowd, everything, the same. That chariot is, I think, still there. That was used in those days. अभी भी उसी भगवान की तस्वीर बिठा के जगन्नाथ जी का and सुभद्रा जी का and all that. Again, they take it round. So it's a great occasion. So to imagine that this was the very place that Sri Ramakrishna had pulled the chariot and that's being enacted again. So this is how we know in that way. You know, we are extremely fortunate because we have come so near to the time of Sri Ramakrishna. Abhi bhi kai cheez unhone vyavahar kiya, unhone samay jo hua tha, again they are being repeated. Only thing is, we have to go to such places and again try to live in that atmosphere, try to connect to that spiritual vibration, so that, you know, it becomes a great help in our sadhana. Then, you know, this fakir was wahan pujari bhi the, lekin wo Sri Ramakrishna mein bahut shraddha bhakti karte the. So he was living at Balram's house. He went to school and also tutored Balram's only son, Ramakrishna. Fakir was a sincere and devout person, and he became dedicated to the master at their first meeting. The master was fond of listening to him singing hymns, and one day taught him how to slowly and distinctly recite every word of Shankara's hymn on Kali. I think it's Bhavani Ashtakam. Atato namata nabandhur. So he taught him. That evening, the master took Fakir to the northern veranda of the room he was staying and touched him while in ecstasy and asked him to meditate. As a result, Fakir had wonderful visions and experiences. As he knows, Ramakrishna slowly, you know, as time was nearing for his exit from this material plane, as far as possible, he was giving extremely liberally all his spiritual treasures. So fakir ke liye unka isi sparsh kiya, itna unka darshanadi hua, he was simply overwhelmed. Now the devotees began to sing kirtan and pull the chariot. The master also took hold of the chariot rope and pulled briefly. Well, in ecstasy, he began to dance rhythmically. Charmed with that ecstatic dance and the loud roar of spiritual excitement, the devotees were overwhelmed with devotion as they pulled the chariot around the rectangular upper veranda at the front of the house, singing and dancing. The kirtan finally ended by glorifying the names of Jagannath, Govinda, Radha and Chaitanya and his companions and the devotees. Afterwards, the image of Jagannath was taken from the chariot and transferred to an attic room on the third floor. Gundichar, उसकी काल्पनिक वही जगह पे अलग रखते थे. अगेन ऑन द रिटर्न चैरियट डे दे विल अगेन पुट इट ऑन द चैरियट एंड अगेन ऑन द रथ एंड अगेन टेक इट राउंड. दिस वाज मेंट टू सिंबलाइज दैट जगन्नाथ हैड गॉन टू अ डिफरेंट प्लेस एंड आफ्टर 7 days वुड रिटर्न टू हिज चैरियट. आफ्टर इंस्टॉलिंग द जगन्नाथ इन द एटिक रूम, द प्रीस्ट ऑफर्ड फूड टू हिम. द प्रसाद वाज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड फर्स्ट टू द मास्टर एंड देन टू द डिवोटीज. He spent the night at Balram's house, but the devotees returned to their home. At 8 or 9 in the morning, a boat was obtained for master's return to Dakshineswar. So, us samay wahan se nikalne ke pehle wo andar gaya sabke saath, ye sabko thoda baatchit karke, the family members and others, and he was coming out. So the devotees, so particularly the lady devotees, they would only come to up to certain distance and then they would go back. So sab aaye the, they were all returning back sadly. After one crossed the roof, there were 3 or 4 steps up, then a door that opened upon the rectangular veranda in the front portion. Most of the women stopped where the roof ended, But one of them was so overwhelmed with devotion that she was not aware of her surroundings. Ek mahila unhone sab to wapas chale gaye, but she continued to walk along with Sri Ramakrishna. वो वही जगह जितने दूर तक वो जा सकती है उसकी पार करके चले गए, वो याद भी नहीं था उनका. She simply followed because she was so much attracted by Sri Ramakrishna's that spiritual ecstasy and mood. Most of the women stopped. She was not even aware of her surroundings. She followed the master to the rectangular veranda and appeared before the unfamiliar men assembled there. उस दिन तो बाहरी अचिंतित अपरिचित व्यक्ति के सामने तो नहीं आते थे. So still she was there. After he took his leave of the women devotees, the master was walking in such an abstracted mood that he was not at all aware that the women devotees had followed him and then returned, and that one of them was still following him. Only those who have seen the master walk in that manner will understand how extraordinary it was. It is difficult to explain it to others. As a result of practicing concentration for 12 years, nay, for his whole life, the master's mind had become so one-pointed that whatever action he set to it, it remained there, oblivious to distractions. His body and senses were so well controlled that they expressed whatever mood was in his mind without wavering. They could not play pranks on him. It is hard to explain this because when we look at our own minds, it seems as if all the contending thoughts reign there simultaneously, and the thoughts that are comparatively strong by habit run of their own accord, disobeying the body and senses. What a difference between the constitution of the master's mind and that of ours. So he says, ehi tarah bahut ghatna Sri Ramakrishna ke jeevan mein hua. All those skin can be mentioned here. Kabhi wo apna ghar se kali mandir, maa ki mandir jate the. आप लोग तो जानते हैं वहाँ से सीधा जा सकते हैं, लेकिन बीच में एक साइड में आपके सब शिव मंदिर आ रहा है, दूसरी साइड में राधाकांत मंदिर के पार करके ही जाना है. लेकिन जब वो घर से निकलते थे माँ के मंदिर में जाना ही संकल्प करके, कहाँ भी नहीं रुकते थे, स्ट्रेट ही वुड गो. नॉर्मली व्हेन वी गो वी डू प्रणाम्स ऑन द वे एंड देन गो, बट ही सेज सिंपली दे कुडंट इवन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई इज इट दैट इज गोइंग सो फास्ट एंड स्ट्रेट टू द मदर्स टेम्पल. He could have bowed down at first to the deities in this temple, this Radhakanda temple, and then gone to the Kali temple. But he was unable to do that. He always went directly to the Kali temple and bowed down. And then on his way back, he would visit the Radhakanda temple. We thought that the master did this because he loved the mother more. But one day he told us, well, can you tell me why this is? When I intend to see Mother Kali, I have to go directly to her temple. I have no choice other than to go there. I can't wander elsewhere or visit the Radhakanda temple. It is as if someone drags my feet straight to the Kali temple and doesn't let me turn this way or that. After seeing Mother Kali, I can go to other places. Can you tell me why this is? क्यों ऐसा मेरा हो रहा है? मैं जब कहाँ कोई जाने का कुछ करने का संकल्प किया तो वही करना है. बीच में कहाँ नहीं रुक सकते. कोई जबरदस्ती मेरे को लेके जा रहा है, ऐसा मेरा अनुभव क्यों हो रहा है? एक्चुअली आई थिंक दैट इज बिकॉज नो ऑफ हिज एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी प्योरिटी द प्रैक्टिस सच इंटेंस पावर्स ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. नॉट ओनली दैट, नो, इट इज ऑल इन अ नॉर्मल लैंग्वेज. इट इज नॉट इवन पॉसिबल टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाई इट वॉज हैपनिंग. नो, कई जगह पे पहले भी लिखा, कब जब ध्यान करने के लिए बैठते थे, समबडी वॉज लॉकिंग अप ऑल द जॉइंट्स इन हिज बॉडी एंड यू वोंट इवन अलाउ हिम टू गेट अप. 5-6 घंटे के पहले नहीं वहाँ से उठ भी जा सकते थे, बैठना पड़ता. देन समबडी विल अगेन अनलॉक एंड देन यू वुड गेट अप. सी दीज आर ऑल, यू नो, दीज थिंग्स कैन नॉट बी एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय अवर नॉर्मल वर्ड्स और अवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, क्योंकि बिकॉज यू नो इवन स्पिरिचुअल एक्सपीरियंसेस द लाइफ्स ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल जायंट्स स्पिरिचुअल ग्रेट्स लिटरल अवतार अवतार मान की भी छोड़ ही दीजिए बात. इवन अदरवाइज हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल अनलेस we ourselves are great sadhakas, we cannot even have a glimpse of or even just an indication as to what he was passing through. We replied, we don't know, sir. We thought to ourselves, why is this not possible? If he wishes, he can easily visit the Radhakanda temple first. Perhaps his desire to see Mother Kali is greater. Wo maa ki bahut hi zyada se zyada pyar kar rahe hain, isiliye wo seedha ja rahe hain. Lekin he himself would answer, you see, whenever I decide to do something, I have to do it immediately. I can't wait for a moment. Everything, you know, suppose kahan jana hai, to turant jana hai. So everything, you know, even there was a barn Ganga mein, that flow, immediately he would run without dropping his clothes, everything, turant dekhna hai. So everything, you know, when the mind becomes so powerful, so concentrated, it is capable of achieving things in a trice, in a second. साधारण व्यक्ति में मान लीजिए आपको मन की थोड़ा एकाग्रता लाने के लिए कितना घंटा बैठना पड़ता है, उसकी बाद ही थोड़ा एकाग्रता आ सकता है. लेकिन हिज माइंड वॉज सो पावरफुल, सो बेरफ्ट ऑफ एनी अदर डिस्ट्रैक्शंस और कॉबवेब्स और वॉट एवर इट इज, एब्सोल्युटली इमीडिएटली वॉट एवर ही वॉन्टेड ही कुड कॉन्सेंट्रेट इट एट दैट वेरी मोमेंट. सो ह्यू न्यू दैट द मास्टर्स होल माइंड, that one-pointed mind was constrained to moving and functioning in that way. Hugh knew that the master's whole mind was one-pointed throughout his life, and this one particular thought arose, no contrary thought would override it. Sometimes the master said, look, when I reach the nirvikalpa state, there is no more I or you, no more seeing or hearing, no more speaking or reasoning. Everything disappears. When the mind comes down two or three steps, then a divine intoxication persists and I cannot interact with various people or things. If at that time I sat down to take my meal and 50 dishes are served to me, my hand will not move towards all of them to take food from one bowl only. So you see, even you know his divine intoxication also, he says, is even three steps less than the nirvikalpa samadhi. When he's in nirvikalpa samadhi, kuch nahi hai, dvitiya kuch anubhav, either himself, I, you, mera, tumhara, kuch, there is no other idea, there is only total complete oneness. So jab thoda uthar ke aate the, teen char steps, siriya, then he really gets that idea of divine intoxication, and then you know at that time sabke saath baate karna bhi sambhav nahi tha, lekin he would somehow function. Only when he comes further down, then he could talk to people or sometimes joke or participate and do other things. We were dumbfounded when we heard about this state, which was two or three steps below the absolute. The master also said, sometimes I am in such a state that I can't touch anyone. If any one of them touches me, I cry out in pain. Who among us could understand these words of the master? At that time, pure sattva was so prevalent in the master's mind that he would not touch, bear the touch of anyone who had even the slightest impurity. During the ecstasy, I reach another state and then I can touch only him, pointing to Babara. If he holds me at that time, I don't suffer from pain. If he feeds me, I can eat. Now let us continue our topic. You know, वैसे बलराम की घर से निकालते वैसे वो नाव तक उन्होंने गया. Outer veranda, then suddenly he looked back and saw that a woman devotee was following him. The master stopped and saluted her repeatedly, saying, blissful mother, blissful mother. She bowed down to the master. When she got up, the master looked at her and said, why don't you come, O mother? Why don't you come with me? The master asked in such a way that she felt compelled to follow him to the ferry ghat on foot without any reservation. She was then 30 and had never gone anywhere without a palanquin or carriage. She rushed back inside the house and told Balaram's wife, I am going to Dakshineswar with the master. When another woman devotee heard this, she also gave up her household work and joined her. After the master asked that woman to come with him, he did not look back. He went in that ecstatic boat straight to the boat with Yogin and Junior Naren. The two women ran to the boat and seated themselves somehow before it embarked. So you see, I don't know who is that. Joginma. Oh, kahan bhi is in her life it is mentioned, is it? Kahan katham
biography in God.
Oh, vacha. Obviously, you know, she was such a great sadhika herself. Naturally, she felt such kind of attraction to Thakur, and Thakur also knew her spiritual depth and her inclinations. Isiliye unhone bhi kaha, you know, in a small way, you know, you can understand in another avatara, in another time, how just by mere playing of the flute, all the gopis would rush, giving up all their household work. In a small way, the same play was being enacted in a different scenario. Then also people would never go like that. Kahan bhi aise nahi jaate the. Simply she went, followed master, because she was so much enchanted, so much attracted by that divine mood of Sri Ramakrishna. During the journey, the first woman devotee said to the master, "I want to call on God more and more and put my mind wholly on Him, but it is hard to control. What shall I do?" Main kya karo? Main to hamesha hi Bhagwan ki naam leke rehna chahta hoon. Lekin sambhav nahi ho raha hai. Kabhi kabhi main idhar udhar bhatak ja raha hai. The master responded, "Why don't you surrender to Him? Be like a leaf in a gale." Jhode reto patale. "Why? Do you know what this is like? A fallen leaf lies on the ground and moves about as the wind carries it. Similarly, one should depend on God. Let the mind move as the power of the divine consciousness moves it. That is all." Thakur to kaha diya sahaj mein. Ek patte jaise pada hai, uske jaise hawa jahan le ja rahe, you be surrender. It's not easy. See, even you know the leaf, does it willingly surrender to the wind? Uska kuch karna hi nahi hai. Wo to gir pada. Then simply the wind is carrying it. So like that, you know, that is why, you know, the idea is, you know, self-surrender bahut hi bahut sadhana ki baat hai. It's not so easy. Itna sadhan karna, itna prayas karna, koshish karna, this is the idea. To understand finally, sadhan kyon karna chahiye, ant mein samajhna. Sadhan karke pana cheez nahi hai Bhagwan. At that time only, when one does, you know, even that famous example that Thakur gives, they baitha tha, je pakshi, in that ship, in that mast of the ship, the bird that was sitting, wo idhar udhar chari taraf bahut hi koshish kiya, bhatak gaya, idhar udhar gaya, lekin completely it became tired and surrendered. After doing everything, then you know it has no hope. Aisa nahi hai, main bahut achi jagah mein hoon, yahan main rehna achha bhi, ye bhi samajh nahi tha, idhar udhar to jana koshish kiya, but it was not possible. Finally, it had to resign itself because it had no other hope, no other way. And then, but you know, at that time, slowly, it was automatically carried across to the destination. So similarly, in sadhana also, when you do more and more intense sadhana, jab aapki jitna sambhav kar chuka hai, everything you have done, whatever is possible, then it is possible to get some idea of surrender. Isiliye, in Vaishnava religion also, prapatti is put at the highest. Prapatti to beginning nahi hai. The saranagati, total saranagati, where there is absolutely in prapatti, there is even no sense of I am surrendering to God. There is only the Vishnu or the Bhagavan or Narayana, He alone is there. That stage is a far cry. Because you know, initially we have our ego, you have our personality, we have our tendencies, we have our own desires, this, that. Bahut kuch leke to hum log shuru kar rahe na. So there we exert ourselves, do whatever is possible. अंत में पता चलेगा जैसे जैसे आप अगले चलते रहते हैं नहीं मेरा कुछ करना संभव नहीं है लेकिन बिगिनिंग में यहाँ भगवान करेंगे देन दैट मीन्स यू नो दिस ओनली मियर वर्ड्स दैट्स नॉट आउट ऑफ एनी ऑनेस्ट एफर्ट सो एनीवे रामकृष्ण फाइनली सेड दैट वैसे ही भगवान की पास चरण में शरण लेना वही अंतिम बात है दिस इज द फाइनल स्टेज दैट ही हैज क्लियरली सेड प्रॉब्ली ही वाज हिंटिंग दैट Yogin Ma can really reach that state. Usse itni badi sadhika the. So you can, if you try, probably you can go and reach that state. While they were talking, the boat reached the Kali temple ghat. The master got out and went into the Kali temple. The women devotees went to the Holy Mother. And bowing down, they visited the Kali temple. Then Thakur also went to the temple. Then he talked with the other the devotees. Then he sat down. वो नाट मंदिर में जाके बैठ गए वहाँ जाके वो गाना शुरू कर दिया था ओ मदर कॉन्सर्ट ऑफ शिवा यू हैव डेलूडेड दिस वर्ल्ड यू एंटरटेन योर सेल्फ बाय प्लेइंग द वीना इन द ग्रेट लोटस द मूलाधर की गाने टा ओ हर मोहिनी ना ओ अच्छा मूलाधारे की एक टाचे दिस इज ए सॉन्ग ही सैंग Nandakumar ka gana hai. Oh, Sri Nandakumar says that one cannot realize the supreme truth unless you remove the veil of your three gunas, which covers the face of Brahman. So, naturally he was singing while seated in the northern part of the Nath Mandir, facing the Divine Mother. The devotees, some sitting and some standing, were overwhelmed as they listened to the song. While singing, the Master suddenly stood up and went into ecstasy. The singing stopped. His divine smile flooded the entire place with bliss. The devotees remained motionless as they gazed upon the beautiful form of the Master. Seeing the Master's body leaning a little, Junior Narain reached out to hold him. Junior Narain ka, kyunki wo to, he was about to fall, gir pade, yese sthiti. To jaake sparsh kiya, then immediately he cried out in a terrible anguish. Lekin Thakur to Junior Narain ki bahut tarif karte the. He would always had a very high opinion about his pure nature. Lekin us din, he immediately, Master cried out and cried out in pain. Junior Narain withdrew himself when he realized that the Master did not want to be touched. From inside the temple, Ramlal heard the Master cry out and hurried to take hold of him. The Master remained in that state for some time and only gradually regained his normal consciousness. But he could not stand in a normal way because of the divine intoxication. His legs were wobbling excessively. In that condition, the Master crawled down the steps of the northern side of the Nath Mandir to the temple courtyard. He was then speaking like a little child, saying, "Mother, I will not fall. Will I fall?" In truth, when watching the Master that time, one felt that he was a boy of 3 or 4 years. He was saying those words as he gazed at the Mother, depending on her as he confidently made his way down the steps. Shall we ever see anyone else or anywhere such wonderful reliance on God, even in such small matters? ऐसा नहीं है बड़े बड़े बातें कि वही कोई वही संदर्भ में वो भगवान की याद करते थे. साधारण चीज चलते फिरते हमेशा ही हर जगह पे हर समय भगवान के प्रति इतना निर्भरशील जीवन. After crossing the courtyard, the Master reached his own room and went to the semicircular veranda to sit. He was still in ecstasy. The mood possessed him. Sometimes it loosened a little, but would increase again, and he would almost lose consciousness. After being in this condition for some time, the Master said to the devotees, "Have you seen the snake? It is giving me so much trouble." Forgetting the devotees, he addressed the snake like Kundalini. "Please go down, move away. I shall smoke tobacco and wash my mouth. I have not yet brushed my teeth." Thus he spoke with the devotees at times, and sometimes addressed the divine form seen in ecstasy. Gradually he returned to normal plane. Then he, abhi to normal sthiti mein aa gaye, sab bhakt log ka kya hoga abhi chinta hai, khana ki kya vyavastha hai. Then he asked the goli mein kya sabji sabji hai kya. Then she said no. Then he was worried, abhi kya hoga, kaise sabko khana kaise banayenge. Then he asked those two lady devotees, socho, the Master asked the women devotees who had come to him, "Can you go to the market and buy some vegetables?" Aap kya jaake sabji le aayenge? See, probably no. Later on, Yogin Maharshi went away to Benares towards last days on her own, Brindavan, and she spent her days, and she was not there when Thakur really entered Mahasamadhi. Then she later came back. Probably, no, just a hint that she could go alone and be on her own and face the world. Maybe this was the first occasion. Because iske pehle kabhi to akila kahan nahi gaya. Palki chhod ke kabhi nahi jaate the. So that day she came all the way, leaving everything, and then barefoot she got into the boat. Aaya tha, itna nahi hai, wo bazaar bheja kuch. See, those days, I think people from women from respective families going to market is something unthinkable. But he made her go and buy vegetables and all that, probably giving a hint that what was to come in her life. Because I say, she had become virtually like a wandering nun. Wahi sanya, wahi vesh dharan karke, wo akile chale gaye Vrindavan. So that is probably, that was the first time when he really put her to that kind of test. Itna nahi hai, maa ki jeevan mein bhi, there was one I think her name was Kya Sarjubala somebody. She was also a child widow. Oh, itna darte te. She was somewhere, she was staying. Ma, okay, samjate te, akila jabardasti vese te. You go and talk to Gauri Ma. Gauri Ma ke kashyam usami bhi toda manali te wo. Wahan vese te, to go, you go alone. Kaise mein kaise mein samjhaoge? Nahi, tumhare jana hai padega. She would force her to go. That, you know, was of great help to the devotee later on. Because my mother knew, after her, what she would do. Who would protect her or where she would live. So like that, you know, these great Mahapurushas, we cannot really understand why they ask people to do certain things. Can you go and buy some vegetable? Yes, we can, they reply. They went to the market, brought some vegetables, Holy Mother cooked. Meanwhile, someone brought a plate full of prasad from the Kali temple. And when he had finished his meal, the devotees had some of the prasad. So later on, uski baad mein, kaise Thakur kyon chillaya wo Naren, chota Naren jab unke sparsh se kiya, kya hua tha? Now he is Satmas giving an answer. Although he was a very pure boy, unka kya kapal mein kuch, he had some growth. So that the doctor had performed surgery and had applied medicine and then still the wound had not yet healed. Look at this, I say aadat hai, practice hai that if you have a surgery or wound or anything, you should not कुछ भगवान के कुछ स्पर्श करना देवता के स्पर्श करना पूजा करना मना है. So because although he was pure otherwise, that particular day still he had that wound. वही अवस्था में ठाकुर के स्पर्श करना उनका बहुत ही तकलीफ हुआ इसलिए. So it was unexpectedly proven to be true that one with a wound should not touch the divine form. This was proved in front of us. Master undoubtedly suffered pain. However, we are unable to understand the inner power that caused him to recoil automatically from that unpleasant touch when he was absorbed in a divine mood and had lost consciousness. We knew that the master had a high opinion of Junior Naren's purity, and when the master was in a normal state, he touched Junior Naren as he did others despite his wound, allowing him to touch his feet and mix freely. How then could Junior Naren have known that the master could not bear his touch during ecstasy? But after that, jab tak unhone that wound was healed, he never touched the master during ecstasy. The whole day thus passed in spiritual discussion in the company of the master. In the evening, the devotees left for their respective houses and the two women took leave of the master and the Holy Mother and returned to Calcutta on foot. Paidal mein dakshineshwar se un log Calcutta wapas gaye sandhya samay. Two or three days elapsed. Then one afternoon, Pandit Sashadhar was scheduled to visit the master at Dakshineswar Kali temple. So, us din unhone Thakur ki darshan karne ke liye Dakshineswar aa rahe hain, isse khabar aaya. Then Thakur became extremely anxious. Kya hoga, abhi aa rahe hain, main to kuch padha likha kuch nahi hai mera. Kaise baatein karun? Then he asked some others, you please, sab raho yaha mere saath, so that you know, you can take care of me. But he had no... So, moreover, there was no way to predict when he would go into ecstasy. When he did that, he had no body consciousness, not to speak of wearing clothes. Sab kapad sab us samay wo utarte the, he was, he had no control over himself. Then unhe jo how the visitor will react, aise koi dekh rahe digambar, so he was worried. One cannot realize God, but he would say, people are like worms. One cannot realize God as long as one has these three things. Shame, hatred and fear. Lajja, ghrina, bhoy. Rane mein Bhagwan ke nahi milega. The master taught again and again. This is this truth. Was the master then a beggar of name and fame? When he tested him, we invariably found that his attitude was that of a little boy who shrinks in fear and shyness upon meeting a strange man. But as soon as he became a little familiar with that person, he jumped on his shoulder, pulled his hair, and freely indulged in various childish pranks with him. If the master had possessed even a single slightest desire for name and fame, he could not have spoken so freely and blunt to Maharaja Jatindra Mohan Tagore and the great national leader Krishnadas Pal. Hey, this Jatindra Mohan Tagore, I think he said, Tagore, he was comparing himself probably to a great person, some Raja or somebody, Yudhishthira. Then Thakur scolded him. Similarly, this Krishnadas Pal talked about charity. Then Thakur ko bhi samjaya, charity aisa nahi hoga, this is not the way. And I think Like that, he had many such. He never, he was not a respecter of persons at all. He even used to bother, whatever it is. Jo batana hai, se bata dete the. And then, sometimes Master was very apprehensive about his visitors' welfare. Although he did not care whether the visitors understood his actions or not, he knew that it would be inauspicious for them if they criticized him because they did not understand. So he was concerned for them. Grish knows ek bar bahut hi gali diya Thakur ke, lekin he was also made importunate demands. At this the Master said, look, let him say whatever he likes about me, but I hope he didn't speak ill of my mother. Meri maa ke bare mein kuch nahi kaha, itna tak main janna chahta hu. Became quite fearful when he heard about pandits coming. Look, be here when the pandit comes. What the Master was that he was an unlettered man and might not speak to the pandit properly, so we should be present. Ah, it is hard to explain that boyish insecurity to others. But when Pandit Sashadhar arrived, the Master became a different person. Smiling, he looked at the pandit steadily, then went into a semi-ecstatic state. Addressing the pandit, the Master said, hello, you are a pandit, please say something. Sashadhar replied, sir, my heart is dried up with too much philosophy, so I have come to you for little sweet devotion. Let me listen to what you say. What can I say? Responded the Master. No one can describe the true nature of Brahman. It is first manifested itself as twin principle, that is Ardhanari. Why? To show that it was both Purusha and Prakriti. Descending a step lower, it separated into Purusha and Prakriti as distinct entities. ये भी मेरा भी ठीक है, समझ में नहीं आ रहा है क्या फिलॉसफी है. ब्राह्मण पहले आधा नारी आधा पुरुष रूप में दिखाया, उसके बाद पुरुष और प्रकृति दो भाग हुआ. आई हैव नॉट रेड दिस एनीवेयर, आई डोंट रियली नो. As he spoke about, is it not, you know, the real रूप ऑफ गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस आर मच बिलो द लेवल ऑफ यू नो प्रकृति एंड पुरुष. इज अ मोर जनरलाइज्ड वे ऑफ एक्सप्लेनिंग द descendants from Brahman to other, then Avyakta to Vyakta, Vyakta to this, and then it goes down. See, this the name and form and all that, they don't come into the lineage at all. You can't put it that way. But anyway, you know, whatever was his vision, why he said, probably it will all be written some years later. Now we really don't know. And then as he spoke about the hidden truths of spirituality, the Master became excited and stood up. He then said to Sashadhar, as long as one's mind is not absorbed in Sachidananda, one can both call on him and perform household duties. Afterwards, when the mind merges in him, there is no more need to perform any duties. For example, consider this line of the Kirtan, Nitayamar Mata Hati. Then how finally, dhire dhire karke, ant mein ha ha karke band ho jate. Then he also said ha ha and then went into Samadhi. Thus saying ha, the Master became speechless and motionless in ecstasy and remained in that state for about 15 minutes. His face was serene and bright and he had no outer consciousness. When his ecstasy ended, he told Sashadhar, O Pandit, I have seen everything about you. You are a good person. After cooking food and feeding everyone, a housewife places a towel on her shoulder and goes to the pond to bathe and to wash her clothes. She doesn't return to the kitchen. Similarly, when you are done telling people about God, you will depart, never to return. इसलिए उन्होंने भी उसके बाद तो उपदेश देना, प्रवचन करना बंद ही कर दिया. बंद करके खामा क्या चले गए. चलो हम लोग भी कहाँ जाएं, देखना है अभी. पंडित सजदे responded by saying, it's all your grace. He then took the dust to the master's feet again and again. As he listened to this master's words, the Pandits were dumbfounded and began to shed tears at the thought that he had not yet realized God. देखिए पहले आने के पहले इतने ठाकुर उनके बारे में सोच के बहुत ही डर आया था, क्या होगा, क्या बातें करूँ. But then the moment he saw him, it was completely transformed. One of our close friend to Master, the following day, we shall now narrate how the Master described that. रूढ़ ने क्या बताया इसके बारे में. Look, there is no book learning here. I am an unlettered man. I was terribly afraid when I heard that the Pandit was coming to see me. You see, I am not even aware of my clothing. I was extremely nervous that I might say some improper thing. I prayed to the Divine Mother, "Look after me, Mother. I don't know any scriptures except you. Please protect me." I told some people around me, "You will be present when the Pandit arrives. I shall feel confident if I see you near me." When the Pandit arrived, I was not entirely rid of my nervousness. I kept looking at him and listening to his words. Suddenly, the Mother revealed Sashadhar's inner self to me. जब उन्होंने देखा सब एक दृष्टि में सब समझ लिया उसके अंदर क्या क्या है वो कितना पढ़ा है कितना जानते हैं कितना उनका really you know is measuring the others was in terms of how much was the realization. उन्हें तो बहुत कुछ जानते हैं किताब से लेकिन अनुभव कितना हुआ. So he would beat others only in terms of experience, not in terms of book learning. So उसके सामने तो before realization, no, nothing. You may learn, supposing, you know, even, you learn so many things you have read about preparation. Lekin aap banane sab baitenge to kuch nahi aayega. What is the use? Unless you are prepared, that is no use, book knowledge. So the more I saw that scriptural erudition was of no avail without discrimination and denial. Unke pe bahut hi gyan, किताब से ज्ञान बहुत है लेकिन जीवन में उतारना इतना सहज नहीं. उसके लिए वैराग्य चाहिए और विवेक चाहिए. तो देन आई फेल्ट अ करंट रश टुवर्ड्स माय हेड एंड द लास्ट ट्रेस ऑफ फियर वैनिश्ड फ्रॉम माय माइंड. आई वाज कंप्लीटली ओवरवेल्म्ड. माय फेस टर्न्ड अपवर्ड एंड आउट ऑफ माय माउथ केम एन इनसेसेंट टॉरेंट ऑफ वर्ड्स. द मोर आई टॉक्ड द मोर आई फेल्ट अ फ्रेश सप्लाई ऑफ was coming from within, just as in a man in Kamarpukur measures paddy. Jab ek karte the na, main maa rash chale diche bolte na, somebody was pushing the paddy from behind like that. So he says, occasionally I have this experience. Jab cook sahab ke saath kaise unko le gaya tha, then there are huge lot of discussions there. Us samay bhi aisa unke anubhav hua. I was nervous that day also and had to go to the pine grove again and again to answer the call of nature. When they arrived, I got into the boat. I had the same experience that I did when the Pandit came. I said many things unconsciously. Later, they said, pointing to himself, "You gave much wonderful advice, but you see, I was completely unaware of it." बाद में कोई पूछे ना आप क्या बताया? नहीं बोल सकते थे. Because no, what he said was completely in a divine intoxicated mood. It was not a prepared or well-rehearsed lecture. How we can understand these wonderful experiences of our glorious master? An extraordinary power enacted its divine play through his body and mind, inexplicably attracting any person. It liked to Dakshineswar and giving that person the ability to reach higher realm of spirituality. If liked to Dakshineswar and giving that person the ability to reach a higher realm of spirituality. We witnessed this but could not comprehend it. But because we saw the results, we realized that those events actually did take place. So, sab jab batate the to samajh mein nahi aata kaise sambhav hai. Lekin unhone pratyaksh unke the anubhav hua, dekha aise ho raha hai, itna parivartan aa raha hai uski jis vyakti ke bare mein kah rahe hain. Naturally they had to believe. But because we saw the results, we realized that those events actually did take place. Many times we saw a malicious man come to the master with hostile intentions, but when the master touched that person while in ecstasy and overwhelmed him with that divine power, his inner nature began to change. From then on, that person would be blessed with a new life. Bahut kai log aisa unke parivartan laya tha. So and then he's giving the example kaise Jesus life of Mary was a courtesan was transformed by mere touch. कैसे चैतन्य महाप्रभु किसी के कंधे में बैठा था. देन हिज डाउट्स डिसबिलीव एवरीथिंग वेर क्वेल्ड एंड ही अटेन्ड डिवोशन. नॉट ओनली दैट दैट जगाए मदाए कई जी परिवर्तन कई सबको घटना जीवन में ऐसे ऐसे बहुत ही घटनाएं हैं. ऑन रीडिंग अबाउट सिमिलर इवेंट्स इन द लाइफ्स ऑफ प्रीवियस अवतार्स वी यूज टू थिंक दैट दो स्टोरीज हैड बीन कंकॉक्टेड बाई जनरेशन ऑफ द डिसाइपल्स. उन्हें सिर्फ तो विश्वास ही नहीं करते थे हम लोग जब पढ़ने के समय. लेकिन जब श्री रामकृष्ण देव के जीवन में प्रत्यक्ष हम लोग देखा सब सबको हम लोग को याद आया वैसे भी ऐसा हुआ था संभवता होने का. What misfortune would have befallen us if we had not met the Master? But after knowing the Master, we are now in the position described by this saying, we don't know how to thatch, but we know the right kind of straw. Bunta janina lekin khod chini na ki, rung ki chakta bada janina. Apna na janina ki ita. But then, we don't know how to thatch, but we know the right kind of straw. Now we are at least protected from accepting anything and everything as religion, be it from any charlatans or from our own roguish doubting minds. Now that we know that one can directly impart devotion, faith and other spiritual qualities to others as though they were tangible objects, you are waiting with confidence to attain immortality by the grace of the infinitely merciful Master. Abhi to hum log ko pata hua, kisi ko sparsh karke seedha se jaise koi cheez de rahe hai, waise hi adhyatmik anubhuti sab karwa sakte hai. Pata chala, sam log apeksha kar rahe hain bhagwan ki kripa se kaise hoga. So let us stop here. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu. In next season mein jab shuru karenge, bahut achhi cheez, Sri Ramakrishna and the company of devotees, the story of Gopalirma, first part, usi same lo shuru karenge.